Welcome back. This is John Locke, and I'm re-recording this video on fixing mobile usability errors in Google Search Console. For those who don't know, Google Search Console is a free tool that you can sign up for. You can verify your website by adding a text record to your domain name records, uploading a small HTML file to the root of your domain, or verifying through Google Analytics. It's something that I highly recommend that you do. Once Google has verified your site and they start crawling your site, they may from time to time send you messages that let you know that you have mobile usability errors or other types of errors that you might want to fix. And we're going to look at three of the most common of these mobile usability errors and how to fix them, how to get them validated. And these are: the text is too small, the content is too wide for the screen, and the tap targets are too close together, or the tap targets are too small. So let's look at each of these. And I just recently fixed some of these on my own website. I'm going to try and find some other properties in my own Search Console and show you in real time how to fix these. So let's go. So this website here is a friend of mine. I built his site. I've done some SEO for his site. This is classicmusclecustoms.com. And I noticed that he has some errors here for mobile usability. Let's say the text is too small to read. The clickable elements are too close together. So let's see if we can fix those for them. When I come to his website, let's look at the text is too small first. What Google is really looking for with mobile usability is a font size that's at least 16 pixels. So if the pixel size is less than 16 pixels, it's going to give that type of error because it's too small for people to read on a phone in some cases. So these fonts all look fine. I know the inner pages on this site, they have the same style, so this all looks fine. Let's check this. I don't know if you can see this part. That looks like it's 18 pixels. Okay, so that looks fine. Down here, this might be what's triggering it. So the footer area, let's look at the links here. That link is these links in the left are 14 pixels. So this looks like it's 14 pixels too. That indeed is 14 pixels. So that's too small. So this copyright notice down here is 13 pixels. So let's see if we can fix that. Okay, so we're going to fix that and come back. Let's take a look. So this is what it looks like when everything is 16 pixels, a minimum of 16. On mobile, that shouldn't be too bad. And by the way, this is a responsive site. You have the same styles on mobile that you do on a desktop. I don't shrink anything down. It just kind of the stuff scooches around. Okay, so let's see if we can fix this other thing. By the way, with this screen that you're seeing here is the old version of Google Search Console. These are all the messages like here for like all the sites that I manage. So there's some in here that are about mobile usability, some other messages about some other stuff. Okay, so let's look at clickable elements are too close together on mobile. Let's see if we can figure this out. So what Google is really looking for with items that are too close together, because not everybody's fingers are the same. You don't have a mouse on mobile. You have your finger and you're tapping things. So when you were talking about tap targets, they want tap targets that are 48 pixels by 48 pixels. That is the tap target that they're looking for, a 48 pixel square. And then what they're looking for with tap targets too close together is they want, in my experience, they want about 26 pixels of clearance between each thing. So one way that I can check this is do this really quick. Let's see if these are too close together. Those look like they have enough room. Those look fine. So I don't think that's the problem here, these. Trying to figure it out. Let's look here. Let's look in the actual mobile menu and see if the tap targets are too close together. I mean, this looks like it's enough room between all these. Let me check. Let me see. Let me see. Top. So I'm going to play with some CSS here. And these honestly look like they're close. I mean, they don't look like they're not far enough apart. So I'm not really sure. What's going on here? Let's see, like margin top, if we do like minus 26 pixels. So if I do minus 26 pixels for each deal, they're not quite bumping into one another. So maybe what I need to do is something like this. Just give it a little bit more room. Maybe something like that. Maybe just give it like one more pixel of room. Maybe that'll take care of it. Okay, let's see if I can find this. I'm gonna fix this really quick. The other thing that I want to look at with the tap targets really quick is this sort of thing where the he has embeds from his Facebook albums, and these might be too close together, I'm guessing. But let's see what we can do here to fix this, because this is a third-party tool called Embed Social. That we're using here. So let's see if we could make it. Little bit easier. Okay, that might give a little bit more room. So that right there might give a little bit more room. I don't think that's a full 26 pixels, but that might give a little bit more room to for people to tap. So I'm gonna fix this. I'm gonna go ahead and fix this, and then we're gonna come back, and what we're gonna do is we're gonna submit these errors as fixed. So let's do fix mobile usability issues. We're gonna click this button. So this is the new Search Console. So it says two errors, two issues. These are valid URLs. These are old URLs. So text too small to read. Validation. We're gonna click this. It says not started. So we're gonna validate fix if we're done fixing it. And it's gonna basically go and try and crawl whatever pages or whatever. Parts of the site that it found these errors on before. But it's not going to validate it right away. What it's going to do is it's going to start a process where Googlebot will go and crawl it and render it. And then sale built to suit. Okay, so here we go. Here's the actual pages where it says that it found these. Take a look. It says this one tap targets too close. No, I'm not really seeing anything out of the ordinary on these. Oh, interesting. Okay, this is something. Okay, so this is something that I need to fix here. says text too small, but honestly, the only things where I see that is here. And it's, yeah, that's the only thing I can see. This is something I actually need to fix here. This is an old album. So what this is going to do basically now that we've started this process, clickable elements too close together, it's going to start a process where it's going to go in and look at all these different pages. And then once it looks at everything, and it might take a few days. It takes a few days to validate everything, but once it does that, it'll give us a notice that either things passed or it didn't. So this is the user agent type for Googlebot right here, smartphone crawler. So basically, it simulates a smartphone. So basically, even though this says right here that it hasn't started the process, it actually has, and it'll tell us pretty soon that it's going to fetch and render those pages, and it's taking a look at everything. So once that's done, that'll be fixed. If you go back to the old Search Console, you'll see that it's validating the mobile usability issues. And we can even check the validation flow process. It says it's started. We can see the details right here. So it's pending. And then once it's done, it'll say passed field other. So here's a site that we launched not that long ago. Here's another site. This is for Industrial Air Filtration USA. And this issue is content is wider than the screen. So let's take a look at that. So this is, oh, okay. So I guess this is already fixed. Content wider than screen. It must already be fixed. Okay. Okay, with the content wider than the screen, usually what this ends up being is either a video or an image or something else that when it's viewed on mobile, it extends outside of the screen and it doesn't fit in the natural flow of the page. If you have to kind of scroll to the side to see what's in there, then something is not right. That's usually what it is. It's usually a video or image or an embedded object in the page that's overflowing. So you might need to get with a developer to fix it. Let's see if I can show you some of the mobile usability issues I just fixed on my site very recently. Okay, uses incompatible plugins. That one's fixed. That was a video that I embedded from WordPress.org. And I hadn't updated that page in a while. All right, so these are some of the things that I recently fixed on my own website. Text too small to read. This is passed. Content wider than screen. I guess this is not available. I guess that's passed. Clickable elements too close together. This one hasn't started yet. Let's look at see if we can find content wider than screen. I guess it's already fixed. So how I fixed mine again, the text too small to read, 16 pixels. I just increased everything to that. Content wider than screen. There is one instance where there is something overflowing the page. So I fixed that. Clickable elements too close together. Remember, you want a tap target that is 48 by 48 pixels and you want 26 pixels of clearance. So let's look at this one. Trust is the key. Clickable elements too close together, it says. Now, some of these pages, it doesn't crawl all that often. But I'm not seeing anything where it's too close together. So I have a feeling that this one will be marked as fixed once it goes back to that. All right. Anyway, I hope this gives you an idea. Basically, the three most common again, to sum up, the three most common things are these clickable elements are too close together, or the tap target is too small, the text is too small, so 16 pixels, or content is wider than screen. And again, with the content is wider than screen, most of it, the time, it's either an image or a video that is overflowing the page. So if you're stuck with that, get a developer, and they can usually fix it pretty quick. And then you submit it in Google Search Console, and it will tell you and show you the flow of getting it fixed. And I hope that is helpful to you. My name's John Locke. My business is Lockedown Design and SEO. I'm here every single day making videos on SEO. Thanks again to all the new subscribers who have come on recently. And until next time, peace.